a comparative they had to establish to take this debate. Why do I think then they failed to do this? Simply put, their definition and their burden of the word average comes out from third speech when they say average is 150 friends. I don't think I know 150 people, let alone come close to making 150 friends. And I think everybody will feel very far short of the definition of 150 friends. But more importantly, therefore, the way this debate has to be seen is similar to what proposition tells you. They tell you that an intelligent person is, by the very fact that they're intelligent, rarer to an average person. An average person will appear more often than an intelligent person because that's how numbers work. At that point, we understand that an intelligent person has unique characteristics which makes that person intelligent. Now, this debate is not about whether or not that unique individual can relate to another individual, but can that unique individual then relate to an equal number of people, if not more, as and when compared to an average individual? And at the point at which you understand that because he has traits, like being more different than other people, maybe being selective, or just having a general different perception to life, he might still have the ability to make lots of friends, but he will find it much harder to do so because of the fact that he is in a lesser number than the average. And that concept of relatability is what really sets proposition theory apart. Thank you.